Are you ready to get down to business? Join seasoned entrepreneur, community leader, and Army veteran, Scott Shalom Klein, who will take you behind the scenes with those who work in America's small business scene and speak with leaders making an impact, creating jobs, and telling their story in entrepreneurship.
So let's get down to business.
On AM 560, The Answer, here's your host, Shalom Klein.
And indeed, we're all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship and business. We talk a lot about business here on with Get Down to Business. And I'm your host, Shalom Klein. Remember, you can always download podcasts on my website at syklein.com. And while you are there, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Shalom Klein. It's going to be a jam-packed week of content and information you do not want to miss. So let's jump right in. Did you know that 55% of working Americans would take a slightly lower-paying job to work for a manager or leader who inspires brilliance? That is exactly what our first guest up on the program, Simon Bailey, has written in State of Working America Report, Thriving in Resilience and Brilliance. Simon has a very impressive background as the world's leading expert in brilliance. Again, he has a fantastic amount of research that has been conducted, and it's been published in his 11th book, Resilience at Work, How to Coach Yourself into a Thriving Future. Quite an impressive background in many different organizations, which we'll talk about over here. But Simon Bailey, welcome to the program. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Good to be with you.
Absolutely. What inspired you to write Resilience at Work?
You know what? As I've worked with organizations, I realize some people work hard enough to keep a job and do just enough to keep from getting fired. And I really wanted to unpack what allows people to thrive in resilience. So that's why we launched the State of Work in America report.
That's fantastic. I'm so glad you did, because I am really passionate about resilience. And I want to talk a little bit more about brilliance as well. But considering the stress that every single one of our listeners, I think it's safe to say we all face daily. What are the top recommendations that you have for building resilience that increases a person's ability to thrive?
Number one, take your meds. Meditate, exercise, diet, and sleep. Take care of yourself before you take care of others. The second thing, reflect on the day. Before your head hits the pillow at night, understand and say to yourself, what went well today? And then the third thing is, as you immerse yourself and you get ready for the next day, decide how you can make a difference in the life of another person beside yourself.
Absolutely. So the book is Resilience at Work, and the book introduces four characters: hurry, worry, ready, and steady. Can you elaborate on how these characters represent different approaches to challenges in the workplace?
So hurry is always three steps ahead, four steps back, never takes time to check in to see how others are doing because it's all about hurry. Worry understands that, oh my goodness, the other shoe may drop. I might get laid off tomorrow. I'm going to lose business. And they kind of live in that land of woe is me. But then there's steady, whose superpower is calmness, this ability to show up and have what many might call this unassuming calmness, this ability just to relax in the moment. And then ready has found their inner chutzpah, ready to take the bull by the horn. Let's go. Let's make it happen. So they meet at a surfing camp and they want to understand, how does resilience really happen?
Absolutely. And which character do you think resonates the most with individuals in today's fast-paced business environment? And why do the majority of people stay stuck in the busyness of work and life?
We asked working Americans, and what we discovered, 56% of working Americans are living life in a hurry, and they don't have time to slow down to the speed of life. 48% of working Americans are worried about the future. So that means every single day you show up in business, there is somebody that's worried about something. So I think practically the first thing we could just start with is, how are you? Checking in with people, extending empathy to them. Then the second thing is, how can I best serve you? And I know in business, a lot of people are like, what do you mean? How can I best serve you? Well, here's the research from Emory University. When you help someone else, the reward centers in our brain begin to light up, almost as if we have been on the receiving end of the person we've just helped, and it's called the helper's high.
Yeah, I'm chatting with Simon T. Bailey, the world's leading expert in brilliance, Again, he has created and conducted some groundbreaking research, The State of Working America Report, Thriving, Resilience, and Brilliance, and has written Resilience at Work with Disney Institute as his launchpad. I know, Simon, you've left an indelible mark on 2,400 plus organizations in 54 countries, including American Express, Deloitte, Visa, and the list goes on and on. So we're continuing our theme in talking about these four characters, Hurry, Worry, Ready, and Steady, which you spotlight in the book Resilience at Work. And they all seem to represent phases in your life. Can you share when you recognized your current state in that season and how did you feel? And was it difficult for you?
I think probably one of the greatest challenges for me in being the worry personality archetype is I have two children that are graduating from college, and I've been a helicopter dad, really worrying about their future. And when I realized I was projecting onto them where I thought they should be at a certain age, and I had to just step back and let them adult, let them live their life and not really take that into business with them.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we are action-driven show. We like to give people homework, whether they like it or not. They will walk away with skills and abilities after this program that they didn't know they needed. And so, I mean, you are the perfect person, Simon, to talk about our homework assignment for this week. What's one daily habit that not only builds resilience, but also moves us closer to achieving our goals?
Carve out 15 minutes a day to focus on you, 15 minutes in the morning or 15 minutes in the afternoon or evening, whichever one floats your boat. Chunk the 15 minutes down into 3 5-minute segments. The first 5 minutes to understand, what did I accomplish today? Second 5 minutes, how did I add value today? Third 5 minutes, how are you going to move forward tomorrow? So what you're doing is you're planning the day in advance to ensure that you hit the ball out of the park. And then tying into that is at 7:30:90. So 15 minutes a day, 7 days a week, over 30 days, and then eventually over 90 days.
Yeah, I'm chatting with Simon T. Bailey, the author of Resilience at Work, How to Coach Yourself into a Thriving Future. And that is powerful, a powerful assignment that everybody, regardless of their background, big or small business, whether you own a business or you work in a company, we all need resilience. And I want to continue on that theme of resilience because I'm so passionate about this, both in my hat in inspiring small business, but also in my capacity in the military as well. Resilience is key. And I have to ask, Simon, can resilience help individuals uncover their purpose? And if so, what's one way to start this journey?
So the answer is yes. Resilience can help a person uncover their purpose. And here's what we discovered. Working Americans said resilience is problem solving, grit, and perseverance. So when I solve a problem, I'm moving closer to being purpose driven and ensuring that I'm adding value to wherever I show up in business.
Yeah, that's awesome. And again, this is applicable for everybody. And I want to talk about relationships. How does resilience in our relationship with ourselves influence our connections with others? And what's one action-driven step to improve this?
When we become whole within our soul and we begin to realize it's not just about me, but it's about we show up in relationships to give instead of get. We show up in relationships to ask, not just tell. We show up in relationships to be an authentic listener instead of having selective hearing.
Yeah, absolutely. So last, as we start to come to a conclusion in our conversation over here, Simon, I want to talk a little bit about that brilliance concept. I know you're passionate about the word brilliance. I focused a lot of our conversation on resilience, but what does brilliance mean for you?
So brilliance is catching the next wave. We asked working Americans to define brilliance, and they said it's confidence, intelligence, and creativity. So I unlock my brilliance, which resilience is the twin. Thus, I release my potential because I'm confident in creating the future instead of waiting for the future to be created for you.
That's awesome. And definitely you're inspiring so many people with brilliance. You have a just absolutely incredible LinkedIn learning platform. And again, you focused on some very large companies, but now you are making all of that work and all of your research and all of your passion accessible to small business owners and entrepreneurs like many who are tuning into this program here in Get Down to Business. So Simon, the most important action item and homework assignment that I could give for our listeners is to get in touch with you and find out more about your book and your work. How can they do that?
They can go to simontbailey.com, T for terrific, simontbailey.com.
Fantastic. Simon T. Bailey, thank you so much for coming on the program. Again, we've been chatting with the world's leading expert in brilliance. We will certainly link in the show notes to simontbailey.com, as well as his 11th book, Resilience at Work, How to Coach Yourself into a Thriving Future. We've got a lot in store for you this week on Get Down to Business. Be sure to get on my website, syklein.com. So you don't miss a single episode. And in fact, check out the archives of 10 plus years of shows and some amazing guests. All of them are linked on my website, syklein.com. And of course, on your favorite podcast apps as well. You're listening to Get Down to Business. We'll be right back.